Antarctica. The uncut jewel at the bottom of the world. Separated from the Americas by the Drake Passage. After 1,000 kilometers of turbulence and rollicking seas, we've crossed the divide. Not just between continents and countries, but between the known and the unknown. Here, in Antarctica, the world unites in the pursuit of knowledge. Year by year, warming seas break apart once impenetrable ice, exposing fragile ecosystems to an uncertain future. As the ice retreats, it reveals frontiers that were not expected to be uncovered so soon.
Antártica significa exploración. Es un, casi un sinónimo. Todos tenemos en mente las exploraciones clásicas y todos sabemos que sigue siendo uno de los lugares más remotos, más inaccesibles y más inexplorados del planeta. Y además hemos decidido como seres humanos, como humanidad, que sea un lugar para la paz, para la investigación científica y que continúe con esa pureza y continúe como está. Podemos explorarlo, pero no podemos explotarlo. Hola a todos y bienvenidos al primer buceo de ROV en el mar de Bellingshausen, en el océano Antártico. Tenemos un equipo internacional de científicos de distintas partes del mundo. Tenemos el objetivo de caracterizar el ecosistema en las formaciones geológicas, ver cómo en el presente y en el pasado el mar se junta con el hielo y con el fondo y cómo funciona todos estos sistemas.
We bridge.
Go for ROV.
Yeah, just to clarify, you guys have a green light to dive whenever you are ready.
Copy that. And this is your happy heading here, is it?
This is a very happy heading.
Yeah, I think one thing I could really feel when we were coming down here is the respect for the courage of the people that came here before us and explored. In much smaller ships, a lot less technology. And thinking about, you know, their experiences versus ours and how challenging it is for us and just how challenging it must have been for them operating with much fewer tools at that point. Dealing with the very sparse information that we had on our charts, we had to rely on a lot of the other tools that we have on the bridge a little bit more than usual.
Let's do it.
And we had to rely on the expertise of the people on board.
Looking good.
Specifically the ice pilot.
I'm standing by for thrusters. You're clear for hydraulics.
Coming up hydraulics.
Coming up now. Roger that.
It was incredibly exciting to enter an area that no one's been before.
Hold it. There you go. Now bring it down.
And be collecting data and putting our eyes on things that no human has ever seen.
As we descend beneath the waves, the surface world fades away. In the cold and silent dark, life has adapted to thrive. Now, for the first time, we glimpse the hidden ecosystems that have evolved beneath the ice. Fragile, extraordinary, and still largely unknown. A solitary hydroid sways in the current. Corymorphidae, a member of the cnidarian family related to jellyfish, anemones, and corals. A single independent polyp anchored firmly to the seafloor by a stem, its tentacles poised to capture prey. With a remarkable capacity for regeneration and, in some cases, a gentle bioluminescence that lights up the dark, these hydroids stand out in a silent, shifting world. Sponges grow slow under ice, often a mere 0.2 millimeters per year. Some may have a lifespan of thousands of years. It's possible when this massive sponge began its life, the pyramids of Giza were under construction. Swarming near the seafloor, krill are the lifeblood of the Southern Ocean. In dense, mesmerizing schools, these small crustaceans fuel an entire food web, from fish to penguins and whales. Though minute in size, their collective movement transfers energy across the ecosystem, underscoring their vital role in this extreme environment. The phantom jellyfish, Stygiomedusa gigantea, is one of the rarest creatures to observe in the ocean, averaging roughly one sighting a year over the past century. It's usually found at extreme depths, often thousands upon thousands of meters, although it's been observed swimming in shallower waters such as these, around 250 meters. Despite the rarity of sightings, it is believed to have a wide distribution in deep ocean waters, particularly in Antarctic regions. The adult jellyfish can reach up to 2 meters in diameter, with tentacles that can stretch over 10 meters long. In the depths, life is resourceful, fragile, and utterly unique. Every species plays a role, forming a web of connections stretching beyond what we can see. These ecosystems may seem isolated, but they are linked in ways we are only beginning to understand. And these first glimpses of a seafloor, hidden beneath the ice for millennia, will offer new insights into our planet for decades to come. Future scientists may one day return here to reveal even more of what lies in the depths.
So when we talk about our oceans, we speak of them as having these strict divides, but really water has no boundaries. We often say that what happens in Antarctica doesn't stay in Antarctica, and that's because really the waters from the Pacific, Atlantic, the Indian Ocean, or the Arctic Ocean, really the whole global oceans are connected here in Antarctica. And this is like at the core really of the field of oceanography, which is a field that studies the physics, the chemistry, and the biology of our oceans.
Antártica representa una especie de termómetro o de centinela para lo que son los cambios, el cambio climático, los cambios globales, al ser un área prístina, representa un laboratorio natural. Poder cotejar en la misma campaña áreas áreas profundas sin la influencia del hielo versus áreas con influencia del hielo nos daría una aproximación a cómo el cambio climático podría afectar a estas comunidades en el futuro.
Obviamente el calentamiento global, hay un factor humano dentro de eso, del aumento de la temperatura, hay una hostilidad dentro del ambiente y chispeante, porque a pesar de eso, de esa hostilidad, la vida prevalece, es decir, encontramos vida donde de repente no debería existir y los organismos están presentes, entonces hay un ecosistema que hay que proteger y que hay que venir a admirarlo, digamos, y estudiarlo.
Throughout our oceans, the movement of water connects distant ecosystems, shaping life across the planet. The currents passing through the Bellingshausen Sea link Antarctica with the rest of the world, carrying nutrients, heat, and even life itself. Understanding ecosystem connectivity, the invisible thread linking species across vast distances, helps us predict how ecosystems might respond to climate change.
It is very important to know how the ecosystems are connected to each other. because the connectivity between the different locations is the basis for the resilience. This means they are much more resilient to environmental change if they are connected.
As ice retreats and new habitats emerge, we discover that isolation is seldom absolute. Beneath the ice and among nations, life connects us in ways we are only beginning to understand.
La Antártica para mí, yo creo para cualquier científico, incluso para cualquier ser humano, significa muchas cosas.
For me, when I think of Antarctica, I think of a remote place and a place that's still very much dominated by nature.
La majestuosidad de la naturaleza como crea esto grandes campos de barreras de hielo, cementerios de iceberg donde se juntan, la vida sobre el hielo, la vida bajo el mar te sobrecoge.
En el anterior salía más fauna.
Особенно нетронутое место, которое пугает своим масштабом и которое содержит в себе необыкновенное количество информации о прошлом нашей планеты, уникальной информации.
Across stormy seas and under ancient ice, we find that nothing stands alone. Antarctica belongs to no single nation. Yet in its quiet depths, it speaks to us all, reminding us that in the end, we're all connected.